futuristico.
Ok, rap futuristico. Rap futuristico.
I don't really think Italy have much of a chance of getting out of the group, I hate to say. I think with the scandal that's been going on in Italy, the last bet scandal, is going to prevent them from really, really concentrating on the tournament. And I believe Prandelli has come out and said that if they could withdraw from the tournament, they would, which I don't think that sounds like a good message that the manager needs to be saying to the journalists and to the players. And in their friendly against Russia, they were just, hammered 3-0, and they just weren't, just didn't seem to have their heads in it. They just weren't out there putting on a good performance. I don't think Italy can put out a performance like they did in 2006 after Calciopoli. That betting scandal, they all came together and they all put in a really good performance. This time around, I just don't think that they have the players and the I guess you could say mental fortitude to go out and to overcome the last bet scandal and everything that's been going on in the last couple of weeks. My dark horses, or really my one dark horse, is going to be France. I think Laurent Blanc has done an excellent job with the French national team. They're in a strong group, but I think that they have a very strong team from back to front. And I know, the defense maybe isn't the best in the tournament, but I think a lot of the top teams, such as Germany and the Netherlands, also have question marks around the defense. But I think maybe they have the best midfield in the tournament. Yann Mbila is possibly hurt. They're checking on his fitness for the tournament, but I think they'll be maybe the best team at the tournament this year. Well, sticking with the France as my dark horse, I think that the player to look out for is going to be Olivier Giroud. He's become one of my favorite players in this last year. As most people may know, he's the Montpellier striker. And if you love great stories in football, then you will know all about Montpellier winning the Ligue 1 title over big-spending PSG. He just notched 21 goals for Montpellier, and there's lots of clubs interested in signing him. So I think that he is going to be a breakout player this year. He's 26, and he and Karim Benzema are the only true number nines that are in the France squad. I've gone with, after scrutinizing the tournament, I picked the Germans. After the World Cup of 2010, I just thought they were a fantastic team. But maybe at that time they were a bit too young to win a major trophy. But now with Ozil and some of those other players in the midfield, as well as they're shaky at the back, but several of the teams are this year. And, they've got Podolski and Klose back in the squad, and they love their international football. So I think that the Germans will overcome everyone and with the trophy. But I'm picking it to be a Germany-Netherlands final. And the Netherlands, I just don't think be quite as strong as the Germans will be.